Hello and welcome to the Chelsea Fans Channel. This is the Palace Preview Part 1. It's the first game of the new year, so we've got the whole squad in to talk about the game. Guys, how are we feeling? Rory, let's start with you.
I'm feeling very full of trepidation, to be completely honest with you. I think it's going to be really, really tough. I think Palace are an exceptionally good team. Very young, very dynamic, very fast. Everything we're not. And I think Pardew's an excellent manager. I think we could have our work cut out. You rate Pardew very highly, don't you?
I do like him. I met him once. He was watching the Chelsea game once and I was in hospitality for the day. Very, very nice fellow. But he was actually in charge of Newcastle then. And what he's done for Palace has been amazing. Yeah. So,
Adam, they're sitting fifth in the league.
Yeah.
Soaring above us at the moment. What are your thoughts? Are you feeling optimistic?
Not really.
That's the spirit, Adam.
No, I'm not either. Optimistic, but the way we've been playing recently, there is no feeling to be optimistic, but they have the energy, they have the passion and everything, and we don't have that.
Wow. We're all going to be down at Selhurst Park on the weekend. Raw,
yeah.
It's a good stadium to go to.
Yeah, it's a great ground. I mean, it really does rock in there. They've got it going, you know, they're Holmesdale fanatics. Fair play to them. It's weird because it's not really English culture the way they've done it. They really have adopted the ultra style to football support. You know, they have drums and massive flags and I think they wear black.
And
but it really does rock. They have excellent away support as well. They're very loud at Stamford Bridge and they battered us at Stamford Bridge.
Yeah.
I think that's the first time they've beaten us at Stamford Bridge since, you know, it was Wright and Bright, wasn't it, up there used to have up front.
So, long time.
Yeah, it was a real surprise result at the time. So we have to try and readdress the balance and get a victory down there. Mm. We played very well down there last season. That's what I'm kind of holding on to. Mm. I remember we scored some fantastic goals that day. Oscar and Fabregas both scored blinders. So I'm hoping for something like that. Can you see?
Yeah. What's your gut feeling telling you?
I don't know. To be honest, guys, I think anybody that's going into this game thinking that we're sure going to win would probably be lying to you because they are, one of the things that worries me about Palace, they're a very fast attacking team.
Yeah.
And at the moment, we didn't even play a striker against Man United. So we really need to make sure that we get the upfront situation spot on.
In fact, you were telling me before, you rate their wingers very highly, don't you?
I think, especially Yannick Bolasie, he could be classed as a danger man. He's got the skills, he's got the pace, he's got the energy.
See, that's interesting. Would you have Bolasie as a danger man?
Definitely.
Do you know what, for me, it's Kabay. I think that Johan Kabay is such a good player.
He's class,
and he really
isn't he?
Pulls a string. He's got a good eye for a goal. But then I suppose, what's his name?
They got
up front, Dwight Gayle up front.
He's always... Well, yeah, he's really... I mean, they've got so... The thing is, they've got so many options up front. We, at the moment, as Chelsea, we have Remy, who doesn't seem to be able to get a game. Mm. We have Costa, who is getting
suspended,
yellow cards, red cards, here, there and everywhere. And he's actually not on form himself. I mean, he got a couple of goals, didn't he, at the Bridge? But we do need him playing to his best and trying to keep his temper on the low, especially for this game. Because if we end up having a situation where he has to go off or he's not on form, their strikers will completely rip us apart.
Such a dangerous thing.
Well, look, let's stop giving Palace too much credit. Let's talk about Chelsea. You know, it's a new year, it's a new start. We've got Gus Hiddink pulling the strings. It's not all doom and gloom, is it? Come on, help me out.
We're all laughing. No, look, it's not, because actually, to be fair, at Man United, towards the end of the second half, or actually, no, throughout the whole of the second half, I did see a lot of fight and passion and determination.
Yeah. There were flashes, weren't there?
There were little flashes, little glimmers of it. Obviously, Matic missed that big chance, which was horrendous, but I did see a little bit more fight in the team. We now need to convert that to having pace, and we need to be putting the ball through to players rather than waiting for them to move into a space. That's our biggest problem, I think. I think everybody else has the initiative to go on and do that, and at the moment we're just not showing that.
I think you're absolutely right. Do you know what's going to be massively important here? That we pick the correct team. So make sure that you join us for part two when we'll be putting four heads together to try and get
part
the
two.
Best team. See you there.
See you in a bit. Now it's a new year, and that's got to mean a new formation. We'll go through the whys and why nots afterwards, but I'll kick us off in goal. Got to be Courtois.